virtual class of Municipal Corporation of Greater Mumbai Education Department. I am Mrs. Akshata Kale and today we will learn maths. Come on, we will begin our chapter. Today's subject is maths of standard 3rd and the name of the topic is subtraction by borrowing. This is part 1. Okay, this subtraction is by borrowing is divided into two parts, that is part 1 and part 2. Okay, you know the simple subtraction, isn't it? Making minus, right? Now today we will learn more about subtraction. Dear children, this is 10 rupees note. You know that, right? Now I need a 1 rupee coins of rupees 10. How many 1 rupee coins I will get? We'll see. 1, 2 rupees, 3, 4, 5, 6 coins of 1 rupees, 7, 8, this is 9th coin and this is 10th coin. Means, here we can write, 1 note of rupees 10 is equal to 10 coins of rupees 1. Means, if I need the change of rupees 10, that is 1 note, then I will get 10 coins of 1 rupee. This you know. You take this change of 10 rupees from the shopkeepers or from your mother, isn't it? Okay, this you know. One more we will see. This is 100 rupee note, isn't it? Okay, here also I need change for 100 rupees. Okay, then I will get how many 10 rupees notes? We'll see. Okay, this is 1 10 rupee note. Second, that is 20, isn't it? This is 3rd. This is 4th note of 10 rupee. 5th note. 6th note. 7th note of 10 rupee. 8th one. This is 9th one. And this is 10th note of 10 rupee, isn't it? Here also we can write here, 1 note of rupees 100 is equal to 10 notes of rupees 10. Means I got the change for rupees 100, that is 10 notes of rupees 10, isn't it? Otherwise you can write, 1 note of rupees 100, if I need the 1 rupee coins, then how many 1 rupee coins I will get? Yes, 100, correct. For 100 rupee note, I will get 100 coins of 1 rupee denomination, isn't it? Okay. Now, here it is written, 110 is equal to 10 units. You know this, right? 110 is equal to 10 units. 100 is equal to 10 tens. Isn't it? 10 tens together make 100. See the 10 rupees, 10 notes together make 100 rupee note. Like that, 10 coins of 1 rupees, they together make 1 10 rupee note, isn't it? Okay, now tell me then, 2 tens means how much? Yes, very good, 20 units. And 2 hundreds is equal to 20 tens, isn't it? If I want the change of 10 rupees each, then if I have 200 rupees notes, then I will get 20 notes of 10 rupees, right? Okay, we will solve some more. See this. 4 hundredths is equal to 3 hundredths and 10 tens. Here 400 is there, na? So 300 and 10 tens. 700 is equal to 600 and the 700 note is changed to 10 tens. This together make 700, isn't it? Now here 900, this you have to fill how many hundreds plus how many tens. Yes, what is the answer here? 900 is equal to, yes, very good, 800 and 10 tens. These two together make 900. Isn't it? Good. I hope you understood this one about the hundreds and tens. Okay? Next thing is, dear children, one sum we will go through. Raj, a boy, has rupees 100 note. Okay, he has to give rupees 58 to Samir. How will he do that? Now, dear children, Raj and Samir both are friends, and Samir brought a book for Raj. So Raj has to give 58 rupees to Samir. Okay, and Raj has only one note, that is of 100. Okay, see this. This is the note with Raj. So Raj makes change of this. Okay, and he will take 10 rupees notes from the shopkeeper. How many notes he will get of rupees 10? Yes, you know that. He will get 10 notes of rupees 10, that is equal to 100. Isn't it? This is 10, right? Now, what he will do then? He will give 100 to shopkeeper. Now, he has 10 notes of rupees 10 each. Then what? How much he has to give? 58. 8 units he need. 8 coins he need, right? So, what he will do? He will take a change for rupees 10 from the same shopkeeper. He will ask for 1 rupee coins. Now the shopkeeper will give 10 coins of 1 rupee. Right? We know that. 6th coin, 7th, 8th, 9th and 10th. Raj took 10 coins of 1 rupees and he gave 1 10 rupee note to the shopkeeper. Now here 9 10 rupee notes are there. Mean this is 90 rupees together, right? And this is 10 rupee. 1 coins of 1 rupee coins, right? So together it make 100 rupees. Isn't it? Now Raj is ready to give 58 rupees to Sami. See here, he uses 5 10 rupee notes, that is 50, plus 8 coins of 1 rupee. Together it make 58 rupees, isn't it? 50 plus 8. And how many rupees left with Raj? Here there are 1, 2, 3, 4, means 40 rupees plus these two. Okay, together it is 42, isn't it? This is 42 left with Raj, and Raj gave rupees 58 to Samir. Got this, children? How Raj gave rupees 58 to Samir? By making the change of rupees 100, isn't it? We will move to next sum. Subtraction by untying a 10. Same thing, we will go through the method. See, this is our table. You know how to do the subtraction. Your numbers are there. Please go through the numbers. 58, that is 5 tens, 8 units. 39, that is 3 tens, 9 units. Now we will always we begin subtraction from unit place, isn't it? And we minus the 9, this number from the upper number. Right? Okay, we will begin our sum. Here what we have to do? We have to minus 9 from 8. Is it possible? No. Right? Because 9 is bigger than 8. So here 8 is thinking about how can I give 9 from me? It is not possible. Then it asked his neighbor, that is 5, and it borrowed 5. Please help me. I want one more here because I have to give 9 rupees to my friend. So what 5 said? Yes, I am sure. I will untie myself and I will divide into 4 and 1. Okay, and 1 I will give to you. 1, 10. Okay, and so 1, 10 and I will become 4. And here 8 is there. So what happens? 8 is already with that friend, isn't it? So it becomes 8 plus 110 is equal to 18 units. Now, what happened? Now 18 minus 9 is possible. Yes. So 18 minus 9 is equal to 9. And here 4 in the tens place it is there. 4 minus 3 is equal to 1. Isn't it? Yes. Got this, children? By untying the 10, we can solve the subtraction sums. One more we will try. See, this is our table and this is our number. 87 minus 79. Okay, same thing is here. This is 7 is smaller than 9. Okay, and we begin from 7, correct? So we have to minus 9 from 7. It is not possible. Again, 7 as 8 to help him. And it borrows from the 8. And what the 8 does here? It unties into 7 and 1. Together make 8, isn't it? 7 remains in its place and 1 goes to unit place. 1, 10 means 10 units. Remember this. And here in the tens, how many remained? 7 remained, isn't it? Now here, already 7 singles are there. 7 units are there. 10 units plus 7 units together make 17 units. So 17 minus 9 is possible, isn't it? 17 minus 9 is how much? 8. Very good. Now in the tens place, 7 minus 7 is equal to 0. What remained here? Only 8 units remain. Got this, children? Here we are untying the tens. Yes, our sum is right. Next one. Here table, one more we will solve so that the concept will become clear for us. Again here 95 minus 39. 5 is there and here 9 is there, so 9 is bigger than 5. So 5 will borrow from tens place and tens it untie its 110 and it helps the unit place. See here, same thing. Right? So 9 unties into 8 and 1. 1 moves to unit place and 8 remains in the tens place. And 1 and 5 already is there. So 1 and 5 becomes 15, isn't it? And 15 minus 9 is equal to 6. And 8 minus 3 is equal to 5, isn't it? Okay. Now, dear children, we will move to the next sum, that is untying the hundreds. What we call this? Untying the hundreds, because 3-digit number we are going to take. Please see these numbers. Okay, 587 minus 395. 587 minus 300. 300, why it is 300? Because it is in hundreds place. This is 90, means 9 tens, and this is 5 units. Isn't it? Now we will begin our subtraction. 7 is bigger than 5, so no problem to make subtraction. So 7 minus 5 is equal to 2. Right? Now here, 8 tens minus 9 tens. No, not possible. 8 tens is smaller than 9 tens. So 8 borrows from 500. This is 500, isn't it? So what this 500 does? We'll see. Here it unties itself into 410 tens. And same thing, here it becomes 10 tens plus 8 together make 18. Okay, now 18 minus 9 is equal to 9, isn't it? And 4 minus 3 is equal to 1. So the answer is 192. What this called? This is called subtraction by untying a hundred. We untied this hundred, isn't it? Good. Procedure is same. Next one. Again table. Number we will take. 369 minus 298. Here again, 9 minus 8. Very easy. That is 1. 6 minus 9, not possible. So it will borrow from 100. Now 100 here, the 3 unties into 2 and 1, isn't it? So here what happens? 16, right? And here it becomes 2. 1 move to tens place, isn't it? So now 16 minus 9 is equal to 7, isn't it? And 2 minus 2, how much? That is 0. The answer is 71. No hundreds left here, so it is 0. Next thing is, we are practicing 2 to 3 sums so that we will become conform in this method. 557 minus 349. Okay, now see this. This is the unit place 7 and 9. We have to minus 9 from 7. 9 is bigger than 7. Again, what he will do? Now 7 will borrow from tens place. Okay, and here in the tens place 5 is there. Here 10 untie and it becomes 4 and 1, isn't it? Here it becomes 17 and here it becomes 4. Now 17 minus 9, how much? That is 8, right? And 4 minus 4, yes, how much? 0. And in the hundreds place 5 minus 3, How much? That is 2. Our answer is 208. No tense is there. Right? Next thing. First we will read the sum. George has 5 notes of rupees 100. Remember, 100 rupee notes are there. How many notes are there? 5 notes. 3 notes of rupees 10 and 9 coins of rupees 1. He purchased a book for rupees 380. How many rupees does he have now? He purchased a book and he gave 380 rupees to the shopkeeper. Now what is the amount left with George? Dear children, first we will write here 5 into 100. That is 500, isn't it? 3 notes of 10. That is 3 into 10 is equal to 30 rupees. 9 coins of 1. So it is 9 into 1 is equal to 9 rupees. Okay, 539. How much rupees he is having? 539. Okay, now we will make a table. We will write 539 up. Okay, and we have to minus 380 because the cost of the book is 380. So we will minus this from the total amount, that is 539. Okay, we will begin our sum with unit place. 9 minus 0, 9. 3 minus 8, not possible. So, here it borrows 1 from this 5. 5, this is 500, it unties and it becomes 400 plus 10 tens. Correct? This 10 tens plus 3 tens together make 13 tens. Right? And here 5 becomes 400. Right? Now 13 minus 8, it is possible. So how much? That is 5. Isn't it? And here in the hundreds place, 4 minus 3, that is 1. So George has now rupees 159 left with him. Correct? Got this? Okay. Now, dear children, this is from your textbook, page number 57. Please try this. Okay? You can use your pencil and you can do the sums in your textbook. Thank you, children.
Thank you very much for being a part of this lesson. Please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon to get new updated videos.